elimination that you manage to snag will be 1 point. And we've been seeing some interesting, I guess, layouts as far as like how that whole, how the whole format kind of plays out here. With the split 60-40, we've seen some interesting results there. Week two prize pool, just as was with week one, is $1 million. All of these players are playing for their share of that incredible prize pool. And the most important part is qualifying. This week, Oceania, Asia, Brazil, and oh, but for now, let's go ahead and introduce your casters. You got Courage JD and Dr. Lupo, Ninja's friend. Take it away.
Wow, Golden Boy, the only thing you're known for is Owl, but here we are. Jack, it's just me and you up front, ready to go, dude. NA East, arguably the largest region. I think I just knocked GB down, but that's okay, because you and I are ready to rock, dude.
I'm spreading peace and positivity. Let's get into the action. NA East, it's time to go. Jesus, what has gotten into you guys? What did you guys have for lunch? It's a holy day today. All right, just continuing to put the pressure on. Down to our top 10 teams now. So already a monster 12-point game for this duo as they look to continue to rack up the score. Saf with one just off to his right. Saf now under 20 HP. Bizzle still alive, gets the elimination on the wall hack. Jack, a name we've seen many times in our passive competition. There goes Bizzle. Down to the hands of Zate and Saf, and they're going to continue to push on through looking for more limbs.
One underneath, directly underneath. We'll see if he can catch that elimination. Declise looks like he does, in fact, go down. Zate is sitting on 10 of his own. The very edge of the storm, 168 total health and HP. He can survive a heavy snipe shot. He can also survive a player dropping in, gets the shotgun shot. Timber goes down, walls off, and gets the follow-up. Every single player he can secure at this point is huge. Another one. K-Doo drops down out of nowhere, but Zay can't get the victory royale as Ubik from all the way in the sky. 2v1. He and his brilliantly done. Needs to begin to drop down.
Cole, his teammate, did just die to the hands of Colin Frags from Envy. Falter and Colin Frags, the duo, still alive. They're falling. Legendian following them as well. 100 Thieves now in the battle versus Falter and Colin Frags. It looks like it's trading back and forth, but the RPG from above does devastating damage. It's now a 2v1v1. Legendian the high ground. The rocket does not connect. Ronaldo drops on in. He's down to just 50 HP. It looks like he'll win the battle, though, versus Addison. Akrian, 1v1v1. Rocket shot from Legendian. Remember, folks, the extra points earned can be the difference between going to New York and staying home. Heads up play as they move across the man-made structures. He can edit the floor. 200 IQ from Legendian. The Rocket with the win. The RPG from the high ground. So deadly right there. And you know what, Ben? In the hit from Addison, breaks the shields. Can they finish the elim? Gets tagged big time, but thankfully, the shotgun shot connects. Rokane went for it, but in the end, it just wasn't enough.
A lot of shield being divvied between these two players. A 2v2 situation, Jack, and it all comes back down to this. Water falling down. Jacob pops himself up there, matches the height. Addison goes for the edit, gets a light shotgun shot from underneath. They're looking for just any angle they can get. This player's stuck in a box, multiple angles here. The shot on the rotation out to the right, and Addison secures one of the two elims required for this win. Descending down, Akri and Addison have Moboy all the way down at the bottom. You see him kind of running around in a circle there, looking for any angle.
This RPG is about
to make all the difference, potentially, if he goes for the reload, dropping in. Both players with the shot, he's out. Moboy can't defend himself from the onslaught of this duo.
Brilliantly performed at the end right there, earning the high ground, keeping control of it, no matter who went to contest it. Great start to the NA, and Perry, who's still alive at the moment, perfect tilt, still 200 HP, enough materials to work with. Maybe can place down a poison trap here if needed, as things are going to begin to get dicey in these next few moments. Player drops in, and Kerry hits him with the 220. Kerry, what a turnaround this has been. drops the turret on down to try to stop this dynamite.
Void and Genesis stuck in a 1v1, fighting for the high ground. Genesis takes the opportunity to pop a couple minis. Void is full HP, full shield.
Oh,
as he drops
gosh.
In, a 1v1 now versus Carry, who pays the price down below. 1v1 atop down. Genesis looking for any shot that he can get as he descends in. A little bit of waterfall to stay in the safe zone, but he's ticking. He cannot take any damage to the Storm Jack. Only 6 HP.
Oh, this is dead. This
48
is dead.
Down below for Void. Looking for the hit, and Void stuck out of the zone, pays the price, and Genesis with the victory royale and two elims to go with it.
6 HP in the end, only one.
Carter will pop, or they've at least transferred the medkit. They should drop down a layer. Whoa. One of these guys on the outside is trying to make a move.
Stretch moving his way up, trying to sneak up behind. We'll see if they catch him off guard there.
They don't have any idea.
Stretch.
Oh, okay. He wasn't actually behind Carter. I thought they had no clue.
At this point, they've got another stretch. Puts the campfire down. Alex and Carter are going to have to apply pressure. They don't want to fight for the top. Meanwhile, down at the bottom, Schmexy gets the elimination. Weiss goes down. It is a 1v1v2. Stretch and Schmexy are pushed into relatively the same zone, and they're fighting out at the bottom. Stretch
and again,
eliminated.
Watch this. Look, critically low levels. They don't care about missing out on a couple of live points. They want the victory royale. That's the number one tiebreaker. It's the easiest way to earn those last points when you have this advantage. Schmexy beginning to spam poison traps down, hoping for maybe some tags on these players. Schmexy now weak. Carter goes down, but Alex is there for the trade. It's like the core of any competitive game you've played. You have a number advantage, you play a trade, it works out.
In front of that player who went in for the challenge. Now, it's going to be two eliminations right now. He's going to be, now this is Saintis and IFABot. IFA, a player, again, another individual we've seen so much of throughout the lifespan of competitive Fortnite. So talented, but let's take a look here at the elevated perspective, because Carry is going to be up above Divine, and then Bugga still going to be in the action as well, and Bugga pushes on in. Does manage to take out Nikiski, sorry about that. And IFA and his teammate are going to go low. There's Saint. Saint just waiting this one out.
That Bugga actually picks up Divine as well to get back up to that effective HP.
Oh, no! Oh!
Down! Saint with the Galaxy Brain level grenade launchers. You saw him take the low ground. He tells you to take the L as he fires those Easter eggs on up. He said, in Happy Easter Sunday, you get to fall.
Man, one could say,
as that other player ticks out, you have packs on the mid tarp. Void and Kiwi Face trying to challenge up, but Void
got blown up.
And he goes into the void, won't be seeing you anymore. Now 2v1v1. Yes, those are two different shades of orange and light orange, I think. I don't know. I'm colorblind. I apologize.
They are. I got you covered.
Okay, cool.
I got you covered.
Bung in the top right, packs in the bottom right. And then you have everyone else, the stack on the wide.
It's coming down to the final moments here, folks. You got Kez, who's going to push into the box, but Pax defends himself, and Kiwi Face continuing to play the safe zone. Fung and Kez with that high ground presence, and Kez is going to drop down low. Fung, they're engaging in two different battles right now, and Pax, well, actually, I thought that they were engaging Pax, but Pax is still going to be in the ultimate low ground. Now, where is this going to be going? Player's going to be right in front of him. Kiwi Face gets absolutely obliterated with the blue pop. A player pops up behind him. Oh, my word. And Fung catches him in the victory royale. But that
might convert all the way.
He needs the resources. He goes for it. He's going to be able to benefit from 15 resources sundown. Three eliminations for this duo. That player is going to be outside, gets the elimination there as well. But four players remaining, a 1v1v1v1 is Seiko and Gage up above. And then you have Oryx and Lou who are in a fight. And Oryx is going to be outside. He ends up eating a lot of damage and will be taking damage from the storm. Players low as well. And you see the shots registering and they go up to the sky. Seiko, what is he going to do? Oh, and then the Oryx just picked up a double down low. It's going to be a 1v1, and he sees him. He's going to land right on top of him. He's got to drift around this. He's got to dodge
your footwork.
Dive and dodge. I can't believe he manages to get onto the
platform.
The humanity, and that is the game. Oryx gets the victory royale off of the player not having any more builds, and he fell. The ultimate low ground, the low ground warrior.
No builds now, though, for Zacity. It's a 2v1 Not often we necessarily see the high ground in this 1v2 situation. Interested to see how P-God plays this out.
Yep.
Could opt to get aggressive, but he will run out of mats first. Zacity is out, but Massif did get the conversion there.
And this is where I'm bummed out for P-God, because they have that high ground. Everything was working out for them here, and they really need to pull out something big time. P-God needs to live up to the name if they want the victory royale. But second place, not bad. I'm sure they would like a little bit more, and there you go. So he's going to bandage out and go in for the fight, but it's getting ticked outside. P-God should be able to survive this if it keeps going like this.
He just needs to wait. P-God needs to wait. He already got a great trade out the first time on Zacity, and that's it. They got way too antsy trying to get out onto him. What happened on the initial trade, they cracked back.
What?
And he had the health advantage on one, and then rather than sending...
be just on the verge of qualifying, on the edge of their seats. Well, guess what? We have the official standings now. Remember, the top three duos will make it on in. Let's take a look at it and see who will be punching their ticket to New York.
Got him!
Well,
you're
done.
Welcome to Jack.
Well,
that's
done.
What I was talking about.
Well done.
Jack, you're beautiful. Did you know that?
Well done.
Listen, when are you going long blonde?
I don't know.
Here it is. Let's take a look at it, and boom, off the top, Wolfgang Krims, OT Spades, $10,000. First place have qualified their trip to New York. Second, Misfits Clicks and Misfits Septic. And finally in third, Envy Lana, as well as Tyler 15. And Zeke, you brought up something interesting for me with that team in third. Lana and Lana, I've heard so many different names for him.
It's French-Canadian, Jack.
I know.
Lana.
But the dwarf.
Lana.
It really depends who you ask.
You know what? He's accepted being called Lana now because we said it so many times the wrong way. It's our fault, right? Well, we take the blame.
It's spelled that way.
Blame the Americans. But Zeke, you mentioned this is kind of a hero story for Lana.